Now here it is, the dream match that so many of the fans have asked for. This is a six-man tag team battle for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, at a total combined weight of 935 pounds, the big cat, Ernie Ladd, along with his two Samoan warriors, Apa and Sika. Corner at a total combined weight of 1,015 pounds. The eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant, and his partner, Dustyrhodes, the American Dream, and the Junkyard Dog.
Now you have it, the introduction. It could become three individual matches, would have been great, but you fans on the Dream Match sent in those cards and letters. And the intriguing six-man team, Apa and Sika, the Samoan Warriors, plus Ernie Ladd against Andre, the Giant, Dustyrhodes, and the Junkyard Dog, Bill Watt. It's going to be wild once it breaks loose.
You really see a contrast. Jack Howell's about a 225-pound referee, and yet he looks like a dwarf out there. And then Ernie Ladd, look at him, he's 6'9", 320. And then look right across the ring, and you see just how awesome, how huge the Giant is. 7'4". And 485, probably going on 500. There's Dustyrhodes' American Dream at 275 pounds. And he is just silhouetted there in front of the Giant. The Junkyard Dog, 265. The Samoans are 300 pounds apiece. This is a great contest. Fantastic. You, the fans, made this match. There's American Dream. JYD coming in there. Catches that forearm that would just level an ordinary human. And it puts the Samoan down, but they're rugged guys. The question is, will Ernie Ladd be able to offset enough with his tremendous athletic ability? Hank Stram said the other day on national TV, when they were having a fight in one of the playoff games, said we need Ernie Ladd here to referee the match to break it up. Told what a great All-pro defensive tackle Ernie Ladd was at the Kansas City Chiefs when Hank Stram was coaching there. Will he be able to offset in any way the awesome power of Andre the Giant? That's the whole key. Because if you can't break the Giant down, you're certainly not going to have Dog and Dustyrhodes helpless long enough to beat him. Alvin Ziegler sure stepped into the frying pan when they came off their suspension. Listen to the crowd. They want Ernie Ladd and the Giant. Everybody that rode in, that was one of the matches they wanted. They went, and Ernie Ladd's trying to avoid the issue. I just wonder one thing, Boyd Pierce. Would any referee in a match like this have the nerve to call a simple disqualification on a match that some 70% of 100,000 fans pick and they know they want to see it settled among these six men? So how tightly would the rules be enforced? I know that as a referee, Jack Howe or any referee would have to be extremely intimidated out there.
Not only how tightly will they be, how tightly can they be?
Here we go. It's the lockup everybody wanted to see. These two giants. Ernie Ladd didn't come off too well on that one. Ernie Ladd, who used to slap around the opposing offensive lines in the National Football League. He was just inducted in the Hall of Fame for the San Diego Chargers. Man was all pro with three different teams. He's not going to physically intimidate this man. There they've got trying to hook him to Andre by the tights. Oh, an open chop. After the Andre in the corner, which has got to be their strategy. They got to isolate Andre. if they can try to go to work on him and take some of his size and strength away from him. And certainly in that aspect, there's three against one. And I got to say, three big men. No one of those men under 300. The Giants just flat pulling the one over the top rope from behind into the ring. Just walking out with him. They can't stop him. He's like a big freight train. Look at that, man. Look at that awesome power.
Using all parts of his body.
American Dream is out there showing the style that made him a world favorite. Last week we saw a momentous occasion for the fans on Mid-South, the actual signing of the contract. Dustyrhodes made Mid-South his exclusive booking agent. And since then, Grizzly Smith had the phones rung off the hook. Vince McMahon of Madison Square Garden, Joe Blanchard, San Antonio, Texas, Jim Barnett and Paul Jones of the Omni in Atlanta, the Baba Group out of Japan, all the major, the Inoki Group, all the major promotions around the world have called Griffin Smith to start getting availability on Dustyrhodes. Ernie Ladd chopping Dusty in the trapezius area. Dusty tags the Junkyard Dog. Dog, that's one thing right there. Dog going to get on against much of Ladd, breaking down as much as he can. JYD, there's a man right there that is the fastest rising superstar on the horizon. He's already captured all of North America by storm, and he's the next superstar, megastar, international star in the wrestling scene. He's already grown into that stature, and we here at Mid-South have got to watch him develop along those lines. The Giant has got the Samoan, the referee down for the count. Ernie Ladd in from behind. That should be a disqualification right there. But I don't think any official's going to call it. Both the Samoans are getting on the Giant. They're slamming him. Took every ounce of strength they had, but they got the Giant down in a lot of trouble. Ernie Ladd is still the legal man in the ring. Ernie Ladd trying to put the Giant. What a feather in his cap if he could pin the Giant. You know, the one thing, the reason the Giant keeps gravitating to the Mid-South area, it's the only place he and Dustyrhodes were ever beaten as a team was in the Superdome. The Giant blasts Ernie Ladd, and then Rhodes, and it's filling up in there. It's breaking down. Giant's pulling Ernie Ladd back into the ring. Dusty and Dog had gotten rid of the Samoans. They're going to double back from Ernie Ladd, and the Giant's climbing on the ropes. I don't even know if they'll hold him. And that's a Giant splash off the ropes on Ernie Ladd. There it is.
And what a smash! And it's a victory for Andre the Giant, Dustyrhodes, and the Junkyard Dog over Alvin Zika and Giant Ernie Ladd. A dream match, and what a dream match it was, Bill Watts. We'll have more great action coming up right after this important message from Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.